Hello, welcome to another week of Children's Church. We are so excited that you are joining us again this morning. We're just going to pray. Dear God, we thank you that you completely change our lives and our lives go from old to new because we know you. Thank you that you change us to be better people and more like Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
It was a very sad day when the king of Babylon surrounded Jerusalem with his army. His name was Nebuchadnezzar.
Attack!
The king and his army stole things that belonged to God. Then they destroyed his temple. The king then ordered that the stolen things be taken back to Babylon. But that was not all he stole.
Ashpenaz, take the brightest young men in Jerusalem. They must be very healthy and very smart, so they can work for me in my palace.
Don't touch those. They are from the temple. They belong to God.
Take everything back to our kingdom.
So the holy cups and plates belonging to God and Jerusalem's finest young men were carried hundreds of miles away to Babylon. Among those taken were Daniel and his friends, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And even though Daniel and his three friends were hundreds of miles away from their home and the house of God, they stayed loyal to God.
Father God, I am yours. Every day I will say, Father God, I am yours. I am a child of God. Cheer me up when I am sad. You make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. Father God, I am yours. Every day I will say, Father God, I am yours. I am a child of God. Cheer me up when I am sad. You make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. You cheer me up when I am sad. You make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. I am a child of God. I am a child.
Among those taken were Daniel and his friends, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And even though Daniel and his three friends were hundreds of miles away from their home and the house of God, they stayed loyal to God.
Are you studying hard?
This is impossible. We'll never learn to read and write your language.
God was with Daniel and his friends.
Your language is very interesting, Your Majesty. Teach us more.
God gave them more wisdom than the other young students, and they loved him for it. In time, the king saw how the boys were 10 times smarter than all the wizards, magicians, and wise men in Babylon. And God gave Daniel something special, the ability to know and understand dreams. It was a good thing, too. King Nebuchadnezzar began having a strange dream.
Arioch!
A dream that kept him up night after night.
Bring me my best magician, wizard, and wise man. They must tell me what this dream means. Well, what are you waiting for?
On my way, O King.
Sleep, sleep. I've got to get my sleep.
O King, live forever.
What do you want to know?
Ask any question.
We have all the answers.
Thank the gods. I have a most important question for you, magician, wizard, and wise man.
No, he's the wizard.
He's the wise man.
He's the magician, O King.
Yeah, sure. Whatever.
Do you want to know what is colder? Snow or a dog's nose?
Or how to turn goat's milk into cloth?
Or the number of giants living inside the earth?
No, no, no! I have been having a very strange dream night after night.
That's simple.
Piece of cake.
No problem.
So tell me what it means.
Okay, but tell us what your dream was.
Then we'll tell you what it means.
Oh, no. If you are so smart, first tell me what I dreamed, then tell me what it means.
You want us to tell you what you already know?
Then tell you what you don't know?
But you'll know if we know what you already know?
Yes, yes, yes. I knew you were smart.
Are you kidding?
No way.
Forget it.
Tell me what I dreamed right now, or I'll punish all of you.
But no one on Earth can do such a thing.
Only the gods can tell you that.
And they don't live on Earth.
That's it. Now I'm mad. I'll not only punish the three of you, but... Arioch! Get rid of all the wizards, magicians, and wise men in Babylon! Well, what are you waiting for?
On my way, O King.
Arioch went to Daniel's house. He told him about the king's order to punish every wise man in Babylon.
Wait, Arioch. Please, don't harm anyone tonight.
Daniel, you're my friend. I'll wait, but only until tomorrow morning.
Let's pray, my friends. God must help us understand the king's secret dream. No one should be harmed over this.
Wake up, Daniel. I've come to explain the king's secret dream to you.
Thank you, God.
Oh, King, there's someone here to tell you what your dream means.
Impossible. Who could be smarter than my wizard, magician, and wise man?
One of the captives from Judah.
You can tell me about my dream?
No, not I.
Is this some joke, Arioch?
But God in heaven can explain all secret things.
Exactly right. You are smarter than all of my wizards, magicians, and wise men put together.
Not me, sire. God told me this secret, not because I'm greater than anyone else, but so you can know what it means.
But what does it mean?
You're king for now, but neither you nor your kingdom will last forever. But God's kingdom will last forever.
Your God is the God of gods, the King of all kings. Your God tells people things they can't possibly know. You deserve a reward. From this moment on, you will rule over Babylon for me and be in charge of all my wise men.
O King, I beg you, do not punish them.
Of course, anything you ask. What was your name again?
Daniel. If I am to rule, I need help. I have three wise friends. Make Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego leaders of Babylon as well.
It shall be done, Daniel.
Many years passed, and after King Nebuchadnezzar left the throne, his son Belshazzar became king. Daniel stayed in Babylon, and every day, three times a day, he faced Jerusalem and prayed to God. After so many years, Daniel was completely forgotten by the new king, Belshazzar. One night, King Belshazzar had a big party. The foolish king used cups and plates stolen from the house of God.
Is everyone having fun?
By drinking from the stolen cups, he dishonored God. He only believed in false gods made from gold, silver, bronze, iron, wood, and stone.
Well, let us thank the gods for this wonderful party. What is that? Wizards, magicians, wise men, come here, quickly! What does it say? Read it to me.
Many meany tickle person.
Many meany tickle person.
Tell you what, anyone who can read those words gets a gold chain.
Eeny, meeny, tackle, parsnip.
Eeny, meeny, tackle, parsnip.
Eeny, meeny, tackle, parsnip.
How about this? A fine purple robe fit for a king. I'll even make you third highest ruler in my kingdom.
Impossible. Infeasible.
Inconceivable.
Is there no one in my kingdom who can read these strange words?
I know of someone, my son.
Tell me, mother, who is it?
In the days of your father, this man had wisdom like the gods. Call for Daniel.
Are you Daniel? The one who believes in the God who created heaven and earth? Look, the gold chain, the purple robe, and third highest ruler in the kingdom. Everything is yours if you can read these words.
King Belshazzar, keep your gifts or give them to someone else.
Oh, then you can't read it either.
But I can, and I will tell you what it says. Your father was so proud and stubborn he lost his kingdom. God rules over everything on earth, and he decides who will be king. You know all this, but you aren't sorry for the terrible things you've done.
My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God. So strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
In the beginning, God made everything. God simply spoke and the world came to be. He sent a flood and made everything new. He parted the sea and let his people walk through.
My God is so big.
Tonight, you used cups and plates stolen from his temple. You have dishonored God. God himself sent the hand that wrote these words, Mene. God has counted the days until your kingdom will end. Tikal, you are not good enough to be king any longer. Upharsin, your kingdom will be given to some other people.
Daniel, I know you speak the truth.
King Belshazzar kept his promise and gave Daniel the purple robes and golden chain and made him the third highest ruler in the land. What Daniel said did come true that very night. Another ruler, King Darius, took over the kingdom. The new king picked three men to rule the kingdom, and since God had made Daniel very wise, Daniel was one of the three. Soon, King Darius saw how Daniel was better than the other two men, and he planned to make Daniel the one and only ruler of the land. That made the other two men very angry. The two mean wise men wanted to make Daniel look bad. But he always told the truth and was not lazy nor dishonest.
We must make Daniel look bad.
But how? He is just too good.
I have an idea. Daniel really, really believes in his God. We will use that against him.
It's me, God. Daniel.
I was right. Daniel faces Jerusalem and prays to his God three times a day.
This plan will work. I can't wait to tell the king.
Hey, it's my plan. I'll tell the king.
Not if I get to him first.
Why, you...
Theirs was a terrible plan, a plan to get rid of Daniel.
Oh, King Darius, you have many enemies.
And we know how to find them.
For 30 days, let's have a holiday throughout the kingdom.
For 30 days, no one can pray to any god or any human except to you.
I kind of like the sound of that.
But here's the best part. If they don't pray to you,
they must be your enemy.
So we throw them into
the lion's den.
By the gods, by me, I like it. A holiday for 30 days.
Yes, a great holiday.
A feast like no other.
I must tell Daniel. It's a wonderful new law.
Daniel heard about the new law, but he was still loyal to God.
He's breaking the king's new law. My plan worked. Daniel is praying to his God.
Let's throw him into the lion's den.
Wait, it wasn't your plan. It was my plan.
Was not. I'm much wiser than you.
Oh, King Darius, we found someone who doesn't obey your new law.
Unbelievable! Who is this terrible person?
He is the Israelite, Daniel.
No, not him.
He prays 3 times a day to his God, just as he did before you made the law.
Shall it be 2 lions or 3?
I can't hurt Daniel. He's a trusted advisor and, more importantly, my friend.
But King Darius, as you know...
The law says no law given by the king can be changed.
Yeah, that's right.
All right. Take Daniel to the lion's den, my dear friend. What have I done? I'm sorry, Daniel. I don't want to do this. You have always been loyal to your God. Maybe he will save you from the lions.
Don't worry. I won't be alone down there.
So that no one would move the stone and let Daniel out of the den, King Darius sealed the opening with his royal seal. King Darius could not sleep that night. He was very worried about his friend. The next morning, King Darius ran to the lion's den.
Oh, Daniel, has your God kept you safe? Open the lion's den!
But there was nothing to fear.
You're up early, King Darius.
Daniel was safe and sound.
I can't believe my eyes. You're okay.
When the lions attacked, God saved me. He sent an angel to close their mouths. The lions didn't hurt me. Because God knew I hadn't done anything wrong. And I haven't done anything wrong to you, O King.
Daniel, I'm so happy. And you call yourselves wise men? Take them away!
That was a terrible plan.
Don't look at me, it was your big idea.
Was not.
Was too.
King Darius wrote a letter to everyone in the world.
Peace and happiness to all. From now on, all of you will respect the God of Daniel. He is greater than any other god because he uses miracles to rescue and save people.
Daniel continued working for King Darius and always stayed loyal to God. And God blessed him for the rest of his life.
By my friend King Dave, wouldn't let the giant stand in his way. He said, hand me my sling, 'cause he's not that tall. My God is bigger and I watch him fall. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. Have you heard the one about this guy called Dan?
Yes, he was a mighty holy praying man. They said, throw him to the den of the scary beasts. But God saved a hero from the lion's teeth. Yeah! My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. History, he will do the same for me, like Jonah and the whale at sea. When I'm lost and afraid, all alone in the dark, you're with me. Oh, you're with me. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. My God's the king of me.